So without too much more ado, let's get into a live demonstration of the quotes module in Dynamics 365. All right, here we are now in the web interface for Dynamics 365. Let me just get a quick plug in here. This is the new unified interface. If your organization is a Dynamics 365 customer and you have not yet switched to the new unified interface, Microsoft is extending support for the legacy interface until October 2020, so about a year from the time that this webinar was recorded. So you have a year to make your switch over to this new interface. If you do need help with something like that, by all means reach out to Profit Business Group or your Dynamics 365 partner. Again, October 2020 is the time where Microsoft will no longer support the legacy interface. So, personally, I prefer the unified interface, this new interface. It's a lot cleaner and sort of more fit and polished, if you will, and finding certain entities is a little bit easier. So let's take a look now at the quote opportunities. If you scroll down your menu along the left-hand side, it's under the collateral menu, collateral section of the navigation menu. So we'll just head into quotes. And you can see right away you're prompted with the view. You can set your default view. I've got it set here for my quotes, but you can certainly see all of your project service quotes, any active quotes. You can see all of the quotes inside of your organization. You can see quotes that you're connected to. You can see quotes that are connected to opportunities rather than created from scratch, and so on and so forth. So you can see there's quite a lot of different views here that you can pick and choose and pin the ones you need. Certainly as well, if you're a sales manager, you may want to pin down quotes for your entire sales team just so you have a good idea of what's going on. But in this case, this particular demo user that I have has set the My Quotes view to their default. So you can see they have two quotes in the queue here, one for 3D printers and another one, 3D printers for Tailspin. And we can see here at a glance as well, we've got one that's been started and it's still in the draft phase. And we have another quote here for $8,500 that is in the active status. Okay, jumping into it then, let's go ahead and create a new quote here from scratch. You'll see up in the ribbon here, we don't have a whole ton of commands while we're in the My Quotes view, but one of the commands we do have is a plus button to make a new quote. So we'll go ahead and do that here. This is the new quote form. Just a quick note here, if your organization is a heavy user of the field service or the project service automation components of Dynamics 365, you may want to try to use these other quote form types. There's one for field service and there's one for project information. Again, the default sort of quote form here is more in tune with organizations that may be doing retail, wholesale distribution, or fulfillment type of orders. So again, we're going to stick with the quote form. You can see here that we've got the new quote details, a new quote name for it. So let's go take a peek at this form just to see all of the different fields we have available to us. We've got a quote ID and a revision ID. Those are both locked for now and will be generated by the system. As we save this quote, we'll get a new number from a number series. As we revise this quote, the revision ID will change as well. We can give it a name. We can select a currency and a price list to look for our products from. We can change our shipping information as far as a shipping method, payment terms, and freight terms. Address information, you can fill this out or you can leave it blank because we do have a field here for potential customer. If you do go ahead and add a customer name, you can click this lookup address button here in the ribbon and that will pull in all of the address information from that account contact record. Now, other than those fields, this form is pretty sparse. Once we enter some client information, you'll see that the form does change, and as we save, some other additional fields will show up as far as entering product information. So let's go ahead, let's make a demo scenario here. Let's go ahead and give a name to our quote. It can be anything that your heart desires. I'm going to keep the currency in US dollar based on the demo data that I'm using here. I also know that this demo data has a retail price list in the US dollar currency. Shipping method, let's go and assign FedEx. Payment terms, net 60. Freight terms, no charge. Addresses, I'm going to leave blank because we're going to click this button here, look up addresses, and that will peel in the information from our potential customer field. And that's basically the last one that is marked as mandatory here by the red star. So let's go ahead and look up Adventure Works, and we will pick the result here. And now we can go ahead and click the lookup address button here on the ribbon, and we will look for an address. We're just going to search. So we've got a location here in the address book for Adventure Works. Do we want this to be the build to address? Yes. And the ship to address? Yes. Again, you can switch those as you need for your quote. So now we basically got everything that we need. If you do want to add a description of this quote, you can. If you are quoting multiple times to a particular customer, you may want to fill that out just to help you determine between the multiple quotes you have. If you have multiple salespeople quoting the same client as well, you may want to add things that help you distinguish which quote is yours or a colleague. So we've got everything in here that we want to have for now. You can see there are more fields. Some are locked, some are not. We're going to get to those in just a second. But I do want to save this quote. So if I clicked off anywhere into any other entity, I will get an error message saying you do have unsaved data and unsaved changes. You should save those. But it is good to get in the habit, once you have your customer information in the quote, to click on the save button. So you can see now that we've saved this out. And here we do. We see that the screen has changed. And we do have this products section. We have some totals that are generated by the system, and we've got our shipping information that pulled in from the AdventureWorks account profile. Okay, so let's get to the most important part of quoting, and that is adding some products to a document that you can share with a lead, potential opportunity, potential client, or prospect. So that's in here in the products section of the quote screen right in the middle. And by you can see we have no items added to the quote now. So let's click on the More Commands button, and we can add a new quote line. We can get products. This is a really handy feature if you've gone ahead and added some products to an opportunity for a particular customer. You can go and grab those product lines in. If you want to grab them from another one order, another quote, for example, that is the sort of shortcut to go and do that. But let's go ahead. I want to show you two ways to add line items to your quote. So we're going to click a new quote line. We're going to wait for this form to line up here. We do have a selector button here to say, is this an existing item or is it a write-in? Write-ins are great if you are adding service charges, one-time fees, setup, shipping and handling type of fees, anything that's sort of outside of taxes and regular fees that you may have built into the form, or if it's one-off products, maybe something that you don't stock or a service, for example, that would be the case where you'd want to use a write-in. But for the rest of the demo here, let's take an existing product and let's search our product database for this carbon fiber 3D printer 15-inch. Okay, we can see that the unit is going to pull in its primary unit. And we have a selector here to override the price or not, so that we can take the system default price of $8,000 for this unit. Now, don't fear if you're a sales manager, if you don't want to give your team this ability here to override pricing information, to override discounts, that can all be turned on and off inside of Dynamics 365. Now here we can change our quantities. Let's say this customer is looking for 5 of these printers. Do we want to apply a manual discount? Now this will be a monetary number, so let's give this customer $1,000 off. They're a great customer. And taxes as well. This is another numeric field, not a percent field. So if you do want to manually calculate your tax, you can do so here now. If you want the system to calculate tax based on shipping address, country, province, state, all those different sort of variables, it certainly can be set up to do so. As well, if you want to have a little bit of intelligence or sort of workflow built into your forms here, you can do that as well. So you can do your if statements. You can do things like if certain thresholds for a price per unit are exceeded, that different fields show, different customization options show. That is all available to be customized here in Dynamics 365. So let's save our new quote line. And let's take a look at what happens after we do so. So there's a number of system generated fields, and those are the ones noted by the locks. So you can see now that we have a total amount. So that would be the five units at $8,000. We can see that we've given a manual discount of $1,000 for an extended amount for this quote line at $39,000. Now, we have some other tabs here where we can go and input information. And again, this is all information that relays to this one line, this one quote product line, the carbon fiber 3D printer 15-inch size. So we can go ahead and change things like a requested date and a salesperson for this particular 15-inch 3D printer. If we want this one line item of an order to be shipped to a different address than the rest of the order, we can do things like that here. And then we can go ahead and add related information. Maybe we want to add a catalog. Maybe we have this as part of a project and we need to add some project information. We can do all of those things in here as well. So let's go back to our quote and take a look and see what else we can add for information. So back here we are now. We see that the product's pane has populated with that one item that we have added. We also have our system generated fields that are summing up everything in that section. So again, the whole quote document is worth $39,000. If we want to give another discount here outside of that one product line and apply a whole discount to the entire quote, we can do that. We can do a quote percent or a write-in dollar amount. We can charge a flat rate for freight if we want to. And then we can also set up our system taxes behind the scenes to generate and get us a tax amount. And then the final sort of net price on the entire quote as well. So now that we have a quote with some items on it and we have some totals, we have it assigned to a customer, we have a currency, we have all these types of things set up, I do want to draw your attention to the different functions available on the ribbon. So up at the top here on your screen, we see we have the new. If we wanted to go ahead and make another quote, we can refresh or delete our quote. But most important here are the ones on sort of the second half of the ribbon. Let's say that this quote now is ready to be shown to the outside world, in particular our client contact at AdventureWorks. We do want to activate this quote, and that again removes it out of the draft status and keeps it active. And we'll just go ahead and click on that button and process this. So now we can see that this quote is locked. None of us, none of our colleagues, or no one inside of our organization can change this quote without bringing back into the draft status, and we do that by clicking the revise button here. As well, if the customer wants to proceed with our quote, we can create this order right from our quote, or we can close this quote. Maybe we didn't quite win the deal. We came in a little bit too expensive on these 3D printers. We can close this quote and it goes into an inactive status, either lost, canceled, or we can further revise it from there. As well, a couple of other handy buttons here on the ribbon. We can create a PDF and we can print our quote for the customer. That will create an output that we can attach in an email, print out, fax, do whatever we got to do there as salespeople. Or we can click the email as PDF button. We get the same choice for reports. We can print that quote for our customer and email it out to the contact that's tied to this account. Process is a little bit more advanced. If you have certain workflows that you need to activate for approvals or for signatures, for sign-offs, those types of things can be built into the processes button. And then the last one here that's really handy is the assign button. Perhaps you are an inside sales rep that creates quotes for an outside sales rep or a more customer-facing colleague. You can go ahead and ready the quote for them. Once everything's activated, you may assign this to one of your colleagues. Sales managers may create quotes and assign them to their teammates as well. So that's all built in here in the assign buttons, just like the share button would be in Office 365. And that brings a live demo here to a close for now. Before I get into the recap, I just want to mention that the functionality we've shown here in the web client is available on the mobile app as well. Now, creating quotes might be a little bit more cumbersome if you're using a smartphone or a smaller screen, but a good use case is if you are a salesperson in the field, you want to pull up one of your quotes and email it out. Again, that's quite easy to do from the Dynamics 365 app interface. So, quick recap of what we went over today's webinar. The option to create quotes in Dynamics 365 is an optional functionality. If you are using another accounting package, different ERP software where you do your quoting, now we can also disable the quotes module in Dynamics 365 to avoid confusion. Creating quotes in Dynamics 365, though, does keep all of your information as it relates to a lead, an opportunity, a prospect, or a client in one central place. And you can use price lists, product lists, or you can use write-in items as well, as we've discussed. We've also noted the quote lifecycle for making revisions and closing quotes. Again, as you make changes to quotes in Dynamics 365, they do turn into a draft status. Once the quotes are activated, they become read-only so that no one can unintentionally change a quote in the system without everyone knowing about it. And last but not least, one quotes can be converted into orders and invoices. So again, keeping the number of administrative steps to a minimum as you bring a quote through your sales process.